Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to be playing some Modern today, and what I've brewed up is a blue-red Delver deck. I'll say right off the bat that part of testing this deck is looking ahead to Spire Bluff Canal, the blue-red fastland from Kaladesh, becoming legal in Modern. I think that having a really nice untapped dual land for two-color enemy color deck is a really nice boost, and not saying it's going to make unplayable decks great or make reasonable decks the best deck in the format, but it is a very noticeable boost. I mean, effectively, it's going to be like plus two life for a deck like this that's going to often have to shock with Steam Vents. But anyway, the other exciting new card for this deck is Bedlam Reveler, which my hope is that Bedlam Reveler can sort of play a similar role that Treasure Cruise used to play in the glory days of Blue-Red Delver. And my deck is structured somewhat similarly with these 12 cheap cantrips, Serum Vision, Thought Scour, and Gataxian Probe to fill the graveyard. My creatures of choice are Delver, Monastery Swift Spear, two copies of Young Pyromancer, and of course the Bedlam Revelers that I mentioned before. Past that, I've been really in love with Blood Moon lately. I played a Teemer Moon deck at the World Magic Cup qualifier, but was looking for something that could play Blood Moon while being a little bit more streamlined and aggressive. And yeah, this my take on this deck is very aggressive. It's actually closer to a burn strategy than a pure control deck. I don't have any counter spells in my main deck, which part of that is making sure that I can make the best possible use of Bedlam Reveler. But I've even got as many one mana burn spells as I could fit, including four copies of Lava Spike, one copy of Rift Bolt. I don't know if that's the optimal way to build the deck, but that's what I'm going to try off the bat here. And just for fun, I've got a Highlander sideboard. I don't think that's that far off from the way you should be building a deck like this, where you can access a lot of your cards through milling yourself. Sorry, not milling yourself, but just drawing a lot of cards out of your library. Having a lot of one-ofs is good, and it also makes your sideboarding very flexible and easy. So that's the deck. We could talk a little bit more about it, but in the meantime, let's join the league. Yeah, I've been struggling in Modern a little bit. My tendency for deck building is to build, you know, defensive or mid-range decks that sort of defend themselves, dismantle what the opponent's doing. That's just a tough way to go about it in Modern because there are so many decks that are so powerful and attack from such different angles. It's like you want to have a chance against Burn, Affinity, Infect, Scapeshift, and Dredge all at the same time, but then you also have to worry about the mid-range arms race of beating the decks with Lingering Souls, beating the decks with Ancestral Vision, beating the decks with Liliana of the Veil. It's just tough. It's a lot to balance all at once. The card advantage in Modern is just not that effective. I think it's a format where you're going to win more if you take a proactive approach like this. So I'm almost just at the point where I'm going to sleeve up, you know, a stock Burn deck, because I think that's a really, really good choice in Modern. And it's a deck that I actually have fun with. I like playing my Wild Nacatls and Goblin Guides every once in a while. But this was my last sort of compromise at building a deck that maybe has a little bit more consistency, a little bit more play into the middle turns of the game, while still maintaining an overall proactive approach. There's a lot of different ways you could take a blue-red Delver deck like this. As I mentioned, you don't necessarily have to be a dedicated burn deck. You could instead play small number of permission spells in the main deck. Like when Treasure Cruise was legal, you used to see permission suites like, you know, two Spell Snare, one Mana Leak, one Remand, just a really small like smattering of various permission spells to give you a little bit more play. I think Bedlam Reveler complicates that, and generally I think permission spells are just not that good in Modern. So that's not my first guess at the best way to build the deck, but certainly would be a valid way as well. All right, so here we go. I'm on the play. First try with a new deck. And I have a one-land hand, but this deck is designed to keep one-land hands. I got a little bit of burn, I got some cantrips, no creatures. But if I'm able to Serum Vision into a creature, this hand's going to be excellent. Going to keep this hand. A question is just, I got to get used to the sequencing of my cantrips here. sometimes you would want to cast Serum Visions and Scry and then have your Gitaxian Probe as a way to draw into your Scry card. Also, I might Serum Visions and find a Monastery Swift Spear, and then I want to have the Gitaxian Probe for turn two. On the other hand, I could cycle my probe right away, give me more information about what I want to scry into with Serum Visions. Not necessarily an obvious choice. But anyway, I'm going to keep this hand, and I think my move is going to be to Serum Visions first. It's good if I find either a Monastery Swift Spear or another Serum Visions with my scry, because then I can draw the scry card on turn two using Gitaxian Probe. My opponent's down to five and has scry to the bottom, so we'll see what kind of defense he or she can muster. Blood Moon, not exciting given a one land hand here, but I will scry that Serum Vision to the top, and then, yeah, the plan's going to be Serum Vision and Probe to find my land. Okay, so it looks like Tron. Got a bottom. And I am going to probe here just because it's so good for me if I do find my land. That's a pretty bad hand for Tron. Alright, sweet. So, sure, no reason not to just put the Swift Spear into play. I gotta shock myself again, but against Tron, life total is not going to matter that much. Urza's mine. And now I get to start doing my thing. So I could either just throw a couple burn spells, maybe Thought Scour, or I could play Young Pyromancer. Young Pyromancer is really going to take like two turns before he starts unloading a lot of damage. And at that point, I might just get all my tokens eaten by an Ugin. What to do here? So I've got 8 points of burn. Actually, effectively 9 with the Vapor Snag, which means I want to get 10 damage out of the Monastery Swift Spear, which I can do over the course of like 3-ish turns. Maybe I should just play Young Pyromancer. I'm going to need to get a hit out of that. Alright, attack for one, play Young Pyromancer. I hope I don't get Pyroclasmed, but I didn't see a Pyroclasm when I probed a turn ago. Okay, just another map. So that means next turn my opponent's going to have Tron, and is going to cast Ugin. So the name of the game is just unload as much damage as possible this turn. Starting with a probe is nice. Yep, so I'm definitely getting Ugin'd off an Urza's Tower. And right now I'm looking at 4 damage, 7, 10, 12. What I'm going to do is fetch for a mountain and then Thought Scour myself. I actually consider Thought Scouring my opponent, but sometimes these Tron decks have Emrakul, so I wouldn't really want to give my opponent a freebie like that. And another thing I could actually do is Vapor Snag my own Swift Spear. That's not that bad of a play in response to an Ugin minus. So just throw a Lava Spike. Swing for 6. Ooh, okay. I guess a swift spear. Will be a fine draw, yeah. Now, actually, do I want to snag my own Swift Spear? Do I want to save the snag for World Breaker? I guess I have to save it. Yeah. Well, actually, okay, let's say I snag my Swift Spear and I suspend Rift Bolt. My opponent casts World Breaker. I go Rift Bolt down to 6, Swift Spear, Fork Bolt down to. Yeah, I need my Vapor Snag against World Breaker. So that's just gonna have to resolve here. And do I suspend the Rift Bolt? I'm not going to. Think I win if my opponent just casts Ugin. If my opponent casts World Breaker, I'm not going to win immediately, but it's not that bad for me. Actually, I guess I should have suspended Rift Bolt. But that would not have been as good if my opponent did decide to play Ugin. I guess suspending here plays around Karn and Ulamog and stuff. All right, it's actually a little close for comfort against the Mulligan to 5. But Blood Moon and Molten Rain get to come in here. Smash Smithereens also good. Some of these counter spells are fine. Not so sure about Spell Snare. It's decent against Pyroclasm. We'll put that on the maybe pile. Searing Blaze kind of poor. Vapor Snag is kind of poor. Though it's alright against Wurmcoil Engine. Think I want all my blue cantrips. I like most of the burn spells. Fork Bolt, mediocre. Young Pyromancer. Young Pyromancer on the draw is just pretty unexciting. Maybe I'll have a couple of Vapor Snags, give me insurance against Wurmcoil Engine. Okay, I'll try this. Pretty sweet hand. Again, my opponent Mulligan and Scry to the bottom. So what do I want to do here? Probably just Island Delver. it's a nice one to reveal. I think I'm going to hold up Spell Pierce this turn. So what I'll do is play Scalding Tarn and Delver. Wyrmcoil Engine. Yikes. That's not what I wanted to see. Alright. So I got to find one of those Vapor Snags now. Get a Sword of Scry with the Delver. Blood Moon would be nice, but I don't have third land. So I'm going to shuffle that away. Probably just grab Steam Vents untapped. Those burn spells are not going to be too good in the face of a Wyrmcoil Engine. So bottom, bottom. Serum Vision again. Bottom, top. I found Vapor Snag. That's good news. I guess I could just block here, huh? I know my Delver's not going to flip. And I know the O-Stone's going to be popped sooner rather than later. So I should probably attack and then Molten Rain the tower. Fate counter, sure. So do I want to add more creatures to the table? Next turn, my opponent's going to have 10 mana, which means that he or she will choose between activating the stone or recasting Wyrmcoil Engine. Assuming I'm going to Vapor Snag. Maybe I just play out everything in that case, or maybe I leave the Delver. But if I just go like Swift Spear, Thought Scour, Vapor Snag. This game's not looking too good. I mean, it's hard to win after taking multiple hits from the Wyrmcoil Engine. Sure. Oh, I should have spell pierced that. What did I do? I'm ready to throw in the towel. I should have spell pierced, but in all likelihood, I was just dead anyway. My sideboarding was fine. I don't see any reason to change. Young Pyromancer, I guess, gets a tiny bit better on the play, But still, it's really bad against Pyroclasm. Possible the third Vapor Snag is a necessary evil here. Not too sure. I'm going to try it as is. Excellent hand. Definitely keeping. Wow, for my opponent, 5 mulligans in 3 games. It's pretty unlucky. Yep. Steam Vents. Swift Spear. Island, Serum Visions. So I'm a ways off from casting the Reveler. Maybe I just want to bottom both. Yeah, bottom both. Lava Spike you. Get in for 3. Well, I guess I sort of just have to hope that my opponent's big threat is not Wyrmcoil Engine, because I can negate a Karn. Not a Wyrmcoil Engine, though. Yeah, that's fine. Ouch. Oh, man. All right. Yeah, I lose. Guess I need, like, Thought Scour, mill 2 instants, draw Bedlam Reveler, draw into Blood Moon and Vapor Snag. That's my out here. I didn't block there, but yeah, I lose. Obviously should have blocked and saw one more draw step, but I sort of clicked through it there. All right, well, that was not really a good showing. My opponent took a lot of mulligans, ended up having reasonable hands, but yeah, just the sideboard life link, life gain creatures got me, so something I'll have to work on.